So you wanna be a super artist? Well, you've come to the right place, 'cause welcome to the Jet Jet Stream. This is a live show, or a love show, whatever you want it to be, where anything goes, anything pees, everything is unscripted, unedited, uncensored. Ooh, uncensored. It is a breezy Thursday night here in the sizzling state of California, and joining me is my pal, my wonderful, lovely bearded afro. Best bud from art school, concept artist, video game designer, illustrator, programmer, animator, creative genius, entrepreneur, founder of Arachnid Games, the awesome Leo Dazones. Welcome to the show, Leo
Hi.
Dazones.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you good. Everybody out there, let me know if you can hear us okay. No, we're
Yeah.
at a little late start. That was pretty scripted. Javon. You got me. You got me. You gotta script that. But right now it's unscripted. This is off the top of my brain. So yeah, welcome, Leo. Welcome to the show, buddy. Finally got you on the show. It was like
Good to be on here.
finding a Pikachu inside the grassy area.
It's like finding a side
It's
job.
like a side duck. And before I
Yeah.
continue, I'd like to welcome everyone else, and we'll do a quick little roll call. What's up? What's up, Faya? Danny Sears. Oh, Danny. What's up, Danny? We were all just drawing earlier, Javonian.
Danny.
So far, that's pretty much it. Sugarpuff, Laurie Numi. And more to come. More to come. I'm sorry if I miss you guys. Quisirst, bunch of consonants put together. I don't. There's one E. Quisirst. So,
So,
are you playing with your cats, eating pizza?
well, I'm eating an apple,
Good.
and
Apple's good for your teeth.
they're good for your teeth.
Yeah, I heard. I heard. I
You
heard.
know what else is good for your teeth?
What?
Mint flavored Oreos, because it
Mint
like.
sugar. Okay. You said mint. I was following you for a second, and you said Oreos, and then sugar.
Yeah.
I'm not sure
So it's like your teeth while you chew.
Yeah, you can enjoy the sugary foods at the same time cleaning your teeth. You guys, if you guys have any questions in the future in the stream, make sure you guys write the little question things can help us a little bit and everything run a little smoother. Man, Leo, how you been? How you been, bro? Bruh.
I've
How you been
been,
out here?
busy.
Well, how's life? I just want to know how you've been. Like, jeez.
Like, I don't know. Life is life. You
Yeah.
never know what to expect next. But yeah. So, started a company,
Yeah.
making games.
Oh, yeah.
So, that's been consuming like most of my life.
Yeah, I bet. I bet.
You know how
You've
it
been
is,
like.
work, just work, and then you realize, like, oh shit, 2 years passed. Like, you just don't really, the time just passes.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out they can see the screen flipping through and not. So, what we got planned today is we're going to look over some stuff that Leo's done, talk about a little bit of our history and stuff, and also I'm gonna draw one of his characters from his games.
Oh,
But
yeah.
how did we meet? How did we meet? Anyways, do you remember the first time we ever met, ever?
Cool, bro.
School.
Yeah.
Brudda.
You want to tell the story or you want me to tell it?
Well, I want to know what you remember from your side of the table, because I was sitting on the other side.
Dude, I met you at the Thanksgiving dinner.
That's right. That's
Or
right.
like Thanksgiving lunch that they had at our school building.
Yeah, it was a fancy feast. It was the freshmen's gathering for the first time, and we were all just scoping everybody out. Just like who's the fresh meat? Who's the competition? Well, we were all fresh meat. And they had plenty of turkey meat.
So yeah. Tell the story.
Okay, I'm gonna tell the story. So, dude, we were eating, and then okay, I was invited. I think it was your ex-girlfriend at the time. We won't say any names. No names allowed. But your ex-girlfriend invited me. Remember that? So I went with her, I think that's what happened. Or maybe I just walked in, and I was like, what? Yeah, maybe that was it. Let's go with that one. I walked into the building, I said, pie? There's pie? There's food? What's going on? This is a turkey dinner. So I walked over, and then I found one of my friends. It was a group of friends, but everything else was a blur. The only thing that stuck out to my brain was Leo with his sparkling eyes sitting across from me, all beautiful and glamorous.
Dude, I put so much glitter in my eyeballs.
Yeah, dude, you had a lot of glitter. You had a crazy night out the night before, probably. Pretty tough night. So yeah, and then it's Leo was just sitting across from me, and we started talking about history and stuff, and we were just putting up. I was just trying to impress Leo with all my stories and my life and where my upbringing and stuff like that. And I was just like, man, I gotta impress this guy. I don't even know who he is. And I thought to myself, man, I'm never gonna see this kid again. But he left a good impression on me. My first impression was like, dude, this kid is really cool. He's really cool. He's just really cool. What about you? You remember that? You remember that? You know what I thought you looked like at first? I was like, dude, you look like Orlando Bloom. Just a different version. You were so slim and petite. Little white guy.
Oh, yeah. At the time, I was.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. You see what Jivian said?
Yeah, what'd he say? What'd you say,
Jivian? This sounds more like a love story. Well, it's a brotherly love.
Brotherly love, man. There's nothing stronger than that. And after that, we kind of like clicked. I mean, I'm probably one of the what your ex-girlfriend really did strengthen the ties. I was like, because I had class with her, and then I was just like, yeah, your boyfriend is a cool guy, and we're gonna hang out as a trio and stuff. So
yeah, the next time we met was like the three of us.
Yeah, yeah, and then we went to your dorm. And we went to your dorm, and I remember the whole entire, I remember that day like clear as day. Do you remember that day? We went to your dorm, and then you're like sneaking me into the back of the side. You're like, you can go into this way, or just avoid the front desk guy. Just keep going. And then we got up there to your room, and then you were showing me, first of all, you're like, you know what, Skies of Arcadia?
Yeah.
First of all, I don't play very many RPGs. I probably played 5 total in my life. That's it. And one of my favorites was Skies of Arcadia. And that's very relevant to his game, once we get into it. But yeah, he showed me Skies of Arcadia. He showed me a lot of his work, showed me a lot of his artwork, and this guy was crazy. I was like, oh my god. This guy is 3 years younger than me, and he's produced 10 times more work than I've ever. And it's just like, what am I doing with my life? This is crazy. So from there, I was just like, man, I can see this guy's fighting spirit. I saw it. I was like, he's got a fighting spirit.
I saw your spirit, too. You had, like, the spirit of Cambodia.
I had the spirit of Cambodia. And then after that, we pretty much tried to get every class together. As whatever class we could, we just kept trying to get classes together.
Yeah, like, man.
We had at least 5 or 6 classes together, maybe even more, I don't know.
Yeah.
And then we ended up living together in Oakland. And then we lived in Oakland, and then we spent some time there. Do you remember the times we had there with the video games? Our first project ever.
Everyone thinks we're in a romance.
Oh shoot, this is not a romance, you guys. This is not a romance. It's not like that. It was like that sometimes, but it wasn't like that all the time. No, we were working for one of our first clients ever off of Elance, and we finally snagged a job after so long. We're like teaming up, and we were so stoked. We're like, oh, we're gonna blow the competition away. We're gonna freaking do crazy work for dirt cheap. And we're just gonna freaking. Why don't you tell that part? Why don't you tell about that time? So what did we do? What did we do? What did we get? What was our first project?
Yeah, so we're on this website that like freelance artists use to find work.
Yeah.
And you know, we had like nothing else to do because it was like summer, semester was out, and we were just basically like putting in all these applications to the different jobs, and finally we got one.
Yeah.
I think it was like $600, which at the time seemed like a lot of money. So we were like, "Oh yeah, dude! Like, totally legit now. We got a job." And it was like doing graphics for the Dope Wars.
we had to sell drugs in the beginning. That's where we were. We were literally making a game about drugs. So it was kind of like metaphorically, we were just like prostituting ourselves, selling drugs.
That's like the artist version of pushing coke on the corner.
Yeah, the job was freaking low paying. We put like, I don't know, hundreds of hours into it, but we're like, it doesn't matter, we're gonna just do it.
Yeah
And we completed that, and then the rest is history. Now
history,
there is history. I don't want to drag this on for too long. Do you have the video game concept art down? I'm not gonna go into that yet. I just want to make sure you have it. But
have like the trailer or image?
No. Just some of the artwork, maybe from the Kickstarter. But
oh yeah.
First of all, I want to ask you, how did you get started in all of this? How did you get started in all this? Because like I said, he had a lot of work even before art school, and if you guys are still confusing, you guys want to follow along, go to his Kickstarter. It's in the description. You can see what this guy is all about. He's working on a game, but I will go through the trailer. We'll play this trailer for the people to see live. But so how did you get started with all this?
Well,
with all of this, just programming, animation, and you know, animation, video game.
Back in the old days, when this was like around 2000.
How old were you?
I was 11.
You were young.
Yeah, man, I was young. Well, I wasn't making stuff yet, but this was like at the time when Newgrounds just started up.
Yeah.
And, you know, back then there was, like, no Steam, no YouTube. Like, mm-hmm. There was very few services online, especially for, like, videos and interactive stuff. And Newgrounds was, like, all these dudes that made, like, awesome games and, like, videos in Flash. So I was, like, holy shit, like, I could do this too. These guys are really cool. So that's kind of what got me interested in creating in the first place. My cat keeps trying to eat my pizza.
Like, let him eat some pizza. I'm gonna draw while you draw a little bit of stuff yeah, while you talk about that. And then
where did I leave?
You were experimenting with stuff.
So I got Flash. Which is like when I first started to make like animations and games and stuff. Mm-hmm. And that was like my first exposure to programming as well, which was like really frustrating at the time. I was just like, I didn't know where to start. I kind of went off of like online tutorials. Like I didn't have a teacher or anything, so
it's just that straight ambition.
It was just like I saw other people doing it, so I was like, oh my god, like I know it's possible. It's just like, shit, how are they doing this?
Yeah.
So, like, that was my very beginning. It was just, like, Flash.
Yeah, and then you produced some pretty impressive animations, and that's what you showed me in the dorm, your room. You were just showing me these little shorts that you did, and they were just, like, trust me. I think you were, like, probably the only 11-year-old in your time zone. Like, not even, like, just in the world. Like, you were, like, the only 11-year-old with that level of quality existing. I was like, whoa. But yeah, you worked on that, and then you worked on your little Flash games.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, and then you're still working on that, right? It's like your baby. Your Flash game.
Don't use Flash anymore. We use Unity.
Oh yeah, what I mean though is like, isn't it? I would imagine something that, you know, like that would back like that. You want to go like explore that later on if you ever had time, right? Like, Fever Dream or whatever. Am I allowed to say that? Oh, shit.
What?
Fever Dream.
Oh yeah, you can talk about that.
Yeah. So Leo showed me this game. You can control and everything and just jump around, and it's still in the works. But he had so much artwork going to it. Anyways, how about this? We can show some of your art. Show some of your artwork from the. Wait, no. Let's follow the thing. So. Once you graduated, how are you feeling? I mean, going into art school. I mean, after graduating from art school. I mean, what are your feelings about all that?
In the last semester, I like went around and showed my portfolio to a lot of companies.
Yeah.
And you know, generally the response I was getting was like, they were like, yeah, like, we like your work, but it's totally not what we're looking for. Like, they're actually looking for very specific subject matter in the portfolio. Like, and it's just not what I had. It wasn't my strength.
Yeah.
So, graduating, I was kind of like, I don't know, a little bit disillusioned. I felt like I didn't really know where to go with it.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. It's just kind of like a last-ditch thing. I started making this game out of ballpoint sketches.
Oh, yeah, Ballpoint Universe. Shoot.
Yeah. And, you know, one of my friends was, like, telling me about Kickstarter. He's like, you should do a Kickstarter for it, man. So, I did. And got some money. And that's kind of, like, where everything started as far as the company was just, like, hey, you should try this out. It wasn't like I planned everything out.
Yeah. So where did you work, first of all? Like right out of school, I mean, because we all pretty much struggled when we got out of school. And they know my story.
The first place I worked
was,
I can't remember what it was called, but it was a frozen yogurt, like a Froyo shop. It was like this Korean-owned froyo shop where I work minimum wage to serve people froyo.
And then the Korean lady was yelling at you all the time.
Dude, there's something wrong with that lady. The thing I did, she was just like,
So, yeah. I just Googled the Ballpoint Universe on the on Google, and if you guys look at my screen, well, it's on display, so you guys can see it. But yeah, continue. Go ahead. I'm just... this rolling.
I don't think it's showing up on your screen.
Oh dear. It is. It's a delay. It's a little lag. But yeah. So yeah, for they can see it. If you guys look at this, my screen, Leo did all the artwork for this game. And you probably dabble in, like, wherever you can, like, pick up, right? Like, programming and texture and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like,
you have experience texturing. I mean, programming. That's what you were doing before art school.
Yeah.
Yeah, so look at this. See, you guys see what the... This is his first game.
Go to the...
Trailer
of it.
Oh, yeah, let's do the little trailer. A little trailer. And that's out of this guy's crazy brain. Let's unplug this thing so they can hear, and then you're gonna have to be quiet, otherwise you're gonna like be heck loud and blare out this microphone, and I'm gonna have to like shutter it in the corner, afraid of loud noises. Okay.
All right, what loud noises?
Oh, there's the loud. a loud noise.
Might have been okay.
There. I don't think I plugged my speakers in. Okay, so this is a this is from Ballpoint Universe, the first title that they released under the under Arachnid Games back in 2013. So we'll just go through this real quick. Check it out. Oh, that's right. That's right. That's right. I'm on the wrong. Hold on. Let me switch out here. Should I just plug it in like this? No. Oh, shoot. This is going to be kind of weird, kind of tricky. Hold on. This is stupid. I'm just going to play it on my other computer so you can hear.
All right.
Hold on. Anyways, I'm going to throw another question at you while I get this set up.
Dude.
Now, how did Arachnid Games happen? Well, we pretty much explained that, but so, Ballpoint Universe, tell me about it. How did that come about?
So, after I got money from Kickstarter, it wasn't that much. It was like $7,000, just over $7,000. But it was like enough to hire a programmer. So, I was looking around, like asking all my friends, like, you guys know a programmer? And I got like really desperate. I was like on Facebook late at night, and I was like, it was Suan. Yeah, I messaged Suan.
You went to like, Suan.
You know. And she's like, yeah, you should talk to Jacob. So, like, me and Jacob started talking, and he uses Unity. Which is like the game engine that we use now. So yeah. We just kind of started working together, and it started off like really slow, but you know, like after a year or so of working together, we got in the game to the point where it was like ready to show off. And I guess that's kind of the period when I would consider that the company started. Because it's like, that's when we started doing what we do.
Yeah.
Of course, like, in the beginning, we like, all had to work out of our living room in the school labs. Because, you know, we didn't have a meeting place.
So how big is your team? Because people won't know, like, these indie game companies are like, how big is the team actually? Like,
so when we made Ballpoint Universe, it was just two of us.
Two people, you guys.
And we brought a third person on once the game was done to like revamp the UI, like the user interface.
Yeah.
And now we're up to four people. And that's
growing little by little, slowly but surely.
Yeah, man.
Nice. Okay, I got the setup. So this This is a little trailer from that, and then we'll look at the other one in a second. Okay, so check this out. Sorry, I know, I'm moving crap around. Let me start it right back here. Hey, you guys. Streaming and then looking through that, it's having... Hold on a sec. I'm going to make sure when we show your new game, it's not going to do this. The thing is, when I had the screen share going at the same time, it was just like, ow! You know, hold on a sec. So, okay. Hopefully it's better. Yeah, it's a little better.
No, the dude can't see it.
What? They can't see it? Huh?
I think they're froze.
Huh. They say,
like, I'm,
what?
Like, I'm, yeah.
What?
Lay on YouTube?
I'm looking at YouTube. It looks like it froze.
Yeah.
No. Maybe it's too much information. Okay, I just refreshed the page.
What?
Huh. Hold on, I think they can still hear it. But they... People, let me know if you guys can still hear the stream. I mean, otherwise, just go ahead and do a Google search or a YouTube search for Ballpoint Universe trailer, and you guys, you'll see this crazy game. I think it speaks for itself. The level of complexity and detail and creativity, it's just mind-boggling. Really, really mind-boggling stuff.
You want me to post the link?
Yeah, that'd be cool. Maybe that.
Let me do that.
Oh, I know what the hell is happening. My computer is trying to back up right now. So, stop that backup. I'll slow it down a bit. All right, so this here is... Okay, here.
That presentation. Oh, never mind. You can post the page.
Yeah. You can't. Do you know if it's they still can see? Can they still see the stream? Like, is it still going right now? It says it's live. But mine's just taking forever to load the comments because it just took a crap. Oh. Hold on, guys. Sorry, we'll get it figured out. People in the future, if you guys are experiencing these technical difficulties, you will be able to fast forward. Just fast forward through this.
Sorry, Matt. The people watching now, use your time machines.
Dude. Oh, internet's good.
How come there's not an apple flavored ice cream?
Apple flavored ice cream, Leo? There, you should make it. They have apple pie flavored ice cream.
Yeah, but that's apple pie.
That's pretty close, though.
There's like no apple flavored ice cream in existence. Or at least none that I know of.
Yep, just the vid you're showing is frozen. Okay, so Faya says they can hear, we can hear, I can hear. Yes, well, good for you. Ballpoint of our universe, I can see it. Great. Cool. You guys can hear it. Okay, so what happened was the desktop is frozen and the... So yeah, let's move on with that one, because...
Come on, I could use mine. Mine's not frozen.
Huh? No, I have, because I have a laptop too, so they can see that too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Stop sharing that.
Yeah, man, apple ice cream.
Apple ice cream would be pretty friggin' awesome.
Hey, the video's back on.
Yeah, it is. It is. The fire! It almost went dark. We relit the fire. Okay,
Oh, yeah, yes, you can marry the art.
Yeah, read those questions. Those comments. So, we're going to talk a little bit about art school, okay? How about that? Because I want to know, how did art school prepare you for this job as a game designer, businessman, entrepreneur?
Dude, talking about art school, well, there's a few ways. I kind of learned how to... Dude, shut it. My cats are like meowing.
I know your cat. Hold on, let me get my earphones back on so people don't...
All right. So, yeah, like you learn how to draw the figure and like
do
a professional figure.
Mm-hmm.
But as far as like entering the industry, I did, which is indie games. There was absolutely no preparation for that. Because, like, I entered school in 2007, right?
Yeah,
we both did. Indie games were not even a thing, like, that year. It didn't really pick up until, like, 2009. So, of course, like, such a new industry is not going to have, coursework yet. But, I mean, in some sense, like, it did help a lot with that because of just the people I was able to meet through school.
Yeah. So, a little disclaimer to you guys, okay? This is about art school because, you know, I talk a lot against it, but I also want to clear up, you know, the good stuff. I will make a video about, like, the pros and cons, you know? It's not all bad, of course. And... one of the greatest things were the teachers that we had. Some of the best teachers in the world ever. We were fortunate enough to have I made a list of teachers, and basically these classes for me were the meat of it all, and these were the teachers I want to give a shout out to who actually made me like who I am today. Like, if it wasn't for those teachers, I wouldn't be joining the way I am. And with that being said, I think I only needed those classes. So those teachers were Zimo Tim, David Chunli, Joko Budiono, Chris Kanga, Stephen Player, and Anne from Color and Design. Out of like 20 plus classes or so, those were really the classes that I felt like that I needed. That was it. Everything else was just kind of like a little bit extra, you know, a little more exploration and stuff. But
do you remember, what was his name? Head and Hands.
Head and Hands. Oh man, he got in trouble because he wasn't drawing for us. Huh?
You walk in like 3 seconds late, and he's like, stops the whole class. Jen, you mind telling the whole class why you're late?
I remember that. Both me and you. Oh shit.
What? It was like if you're like a minute late, and we're like broke.
Yeah.
We were like drive to Bard and pick Bard, and there was always delays and stuff. So, like, of course we're gonna be late.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's like, dude, don't worry about it, man. Like, this is college. If I'm gonna fail, don't worry about it, dude. Nothing on you. You know. And the thing about him was he was really 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 passionate about the things he was doing. But he did two demos. I remember. I counted them, Leo. He did two demos for us. You know, remember what they were? Do you remember? They were one. I think it was an eyeball. And then the second one was caricatures at the last day of class, which is totally not what we need.
Yeah, whenever he drew something in his class, it always had to be like. Like, you had to use the lighting that he used.
Yeah. That was tough.
Yeah, but anyway, I digress. That was still fun.
Yeah, no. I was just saying, like, pretty much, like, 20-plus classes. I kid you not. 5 of them was the meat, and it's like most of them were foundational, fundamental things, like a bunch of fundamental classes, like form and shadow and form and light and things like that, color theory, figure drawing, and all this stuff. It's like you can learn on the internet, and I decided to go to a really expensive school and learn it, which is nice too, because you get to have feedback from the person, and you meet a lot of cool people like Leo. Yeah, Sasquatch.
I'm a Sasquatch. Yeah, and I got to meet a cool dude like Jet. I'm all the it was like, what's up, man? Like, you wanna come over and hang out? And I was like, sure. No, he was put this in your butt.
What?
Just real quick.
What?
No, I'm just no, I get there, and we're both like broke ass, like, you know, freshmen in college have no money.
Yeah.
And he cooked me this, like, he actually like had a movie. He was like, yeah, man, like I'm practicing cooking, like try it out. I was just like, this guy's all right.
Holy shit. Yep, that's what started it all. But let's see. So I'm going over your artwork from the Kickstarter right now. So there's the link to all this stuff. Let's talk about that. Actually, yeah. You don't have to show your screen. I got it right here. If there's extra art for us to see, can you show it to us? Like, I mean, if you can, if you want to. Like some special art, then you can just share that stuff. But
look in the Google Hangout chat. I sent you another link.
Oh, nice, nice, nice. Right on, brother. Right on. Let's do that.
Yeah, so I guess I'll explain a little bit about the game since that's what you're showing now.
Yeah. Look at this, you guys. Look at this. Okay, this is what I'm saying about Leo. Every single time I look at his work, this is what I'm saying, you guys. This is what sets him apart. He is bringing out a vision. He's bringing to life a vision that he had. And he's doing what most kids who are into games and cartoons dream of. He's living the life. And he's creating his world for all of you guys to enjoy. It's crazy. You're the concept. What would you call your role in this whole entire thing? Because you do so much. This is awesome.
I'm kind of like a project director. Because, like, I work really closely with the programmers on the project. Like, we work in the same office. Yeah. Hey, give me, like, 2 seconds. I'm going to...
Do you take those 2 seconds? So here, look at you guys. These are some sketches from the game. This is a little creature for Diluvian. So the game, let's say it now. It's called Diluvian.
Diluvian. Yeah.
I don't even know. I'm just looking at this art. So main concept work for Diluvian. What is this?
Oh, yeah. That's been my role in the project. So.
Oh, yeah.
I do all the artwork. I give model sheets to the modelers and do, like, a lot of game design.
Yeah.
So, like, I'll sketch out the ideas on paper and then talk to the programmers about it, and then we, like, figure out a way to make it work. Does that make
sense? Oh, yeah. So you basically are like the idea machine. You pump out ideas from your machine, your brain.
Yeah, man, I'm like a bottomless pit of ideas. But they're not all good ideas. It's like half and half.
So, do I go previous post or next post? Because I'm having...
Yeah, just click the next button.
Oh, make sure. Hold on a sec. Yeah, I could use some help with my YouTube. Some YouTube help.
YouTube.
There. Large mode.
YouTube.
Because I'm constantly trying to find where the comments are and everything. See Andrew Marr's painting? He
Yeah, dude, he did a sketch of one of our craps.
This is a drawing from one of our friends. Our school. Yeah, I'm getting like single posts. Is there
you load it?
Oh, loading. So can I just keep scrolling down and it'll load?
Oh wait, you're viewing single posts. That's why.
Oh no, I got it now. I got it. There it is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So there's a ship design. Ink.
Shit. They're so fun.
So tell me about it. What is it? What is this all about? What's this going on here? What is this?
All the ships in Diluvian are submarines. The whole game takes place underwater. And it's in the future, and there's no surface anymore. So, like, everyone's in submarines or, like, underwater polymers.
Yeah.
So that is what the deal with Diluvian is.
So what are you drawing on?
The
like when you're playing the game, like you actually have a submarine and like you can go to the inside and see like your crew. It's inside of it.
Yeah. Whoa. I got a 3D model right now. Say hello to the lionfish. Who's the lionfish?
That's the submarine.
You will find out.
Oh, snap.
Yeah, they're saying them skills is legendary. Oh, you guys ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh, shucks, you guys. Ain't nothing.
Some character. See, the thing about Leo is that his style is so unique, and it'll stand out in his games. And that's one of the things about him is his trademark style. And if you guys ever heard of Odin's Sphere, one of my favorite games, I know one of Leo's favorite games.
Odin's Sphere.
The artist of that game is actually the founder of his company as well. And there's no one else who does anything quite like his style. So that's pretty much it. Those two pages. Cool. All right. Let's look at the trailer for this. This time it's not going to be stupid. I don't think. I think they're going to be able to see it. So.
Yeah, I don't know.
All right. So it's going to be a little bit lower. Oh. No. Why does it do that? So if I turn on the mic, it's the mic, okay. So this time this mic's off, sound is on. If I play the sound from my desktop or laptop, and use the mic from that, I'm gonna get feedback. That's what I'm trying to figure out. I'm gonna get feedback, so. This is what I will. All
right.
I will do. I'm gonna do this. There's a fast feedback.
Oh, shoot, Zeshi. He or she saw the crab on Instagram. Joe, you there? You're alive, buddy? Yeah? Whoa. Well, hey guys, it seems Jed has disappeared. I'm sure he'll be back shortly. Yeah, maybe he's in the Nether Realm right now. Or has turned into being a pure energy.
Yes, I'm gonna hijack this channel. Can you hear that paper bag? I have two cats, and they're like, holy shit, they can't get enough of this bag. That's right, the Jenny Jets show starring Leo Dassa. Okay, so what's your favorite fruit?
Leo.
Hey, you're back. Leo,
you can hear me.
I can hear you now.
You can hear me.
Where were you?
With my freaking microphone now, but I'm back. I'm back. Let me know if you can hear me.
I hear you.
Hold on.
I was just trying to take over your channel.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
You hear me now still?
Yeah, I hear you.
All right, anyways, you guys get the picture. His art's amazing. You guys go check out the Kickstarter and then just look at the video. It's amazing, okay? I promise you.
Check that out.
Yeah, I think they've had enough of my little shenanigans.
Wait. Hey, yeah. Carrots are not a fruit.
What?
While you were gone, I was asking them what their favorite fruit is. We got carrots, apples, and tomato. My favorite fruit is a star fruit. Oh, we have two. We got two grapes. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm here. So.
Just checking. I thought you disappeared.
All right. So yeah. What else can you tell me about the game? So you're running a Kickstarter for it. Here, as you guys obviously seen for the past 5-10 minutes, it's the Kickstarter. Yeah.
There's that. What else? We've been working on it for about 14 months.
Yeah. And when do you think it's going to be ready by? 14 months. Yeah. Dang, a year and.
Release in December.
Nice.
Yeah. So, you know, that's a release date and those things always change. So, who knows?
The thing, Leo, we all had different strengths in school. We all had different strengths. And what set Leo apart was that his imagination, of course you guys can see, but also his heart and determination and hard work. And
just as hard working as me.
Dude, we even have similar birthdays. Our birthdays are like 2 days apart.
Yeah,
yours is 2 days apart.
Born to different mothers.
Yeah. But I would constantly feel like sometimes some rivalry, sometimes some camaraderie. Not just from you, but like from just being in school.
Oh, yeah, man. There was always that rivalry in the class, like between the top students.
Yeah. Which again is like one of the most like beneficial parts about being in our school was the competition and the rivalry that we had. The friendly rivalry, we were able to compete and work and push each other to work harder. And yeah.
Yeah. It was like it got really like close. Like an advanced perspective, we had this like really close knit group, but we were also all competitive.
Yeah. And that's that's one thing about these kids, you see, these kids in the art school, like the top students, they make it in art with or without art school, I think, because they were so disciplined and hardworking in school. It's like, if you have that fighting spirit, you're going to do things that you need to do in order to excel and succeed in whatever you want to do. And that's why even people out of art school weren't even able to use, like, Photoshop, or they were still having, like, fundamental problems in their drawing, even after graduating from this really nice, fancy art school.
Well, yeah, because just going and, like, graduating doesn't necessarily mean that you got the best out of it. Yeah. Like, a lot of people go and then graduate, and then, like, there's nothing for them when they graduate.
Now, like, so you got out of art school, and then you struggled finding art, just like a lot of us did. A lot of our friends, you just, like, struggle. A lot of us aren't even doing art anymore. It's crazy. They're like, oh, I gave up. I'm moving home. Yeah. I got deported. I got laid off. You hear that a lot. Like, every now and then, there's just another one who just falls. You're just like, no. Oh, and for Leo, he's a ball of genius, right? The industry overlooked because he didn't fit the mold. So, what did he do? He took it in his own hands. And I think that was like the right fit for you. I think it's destiny almost. Because yeah, you are much more than what they can offer you, you know. I mean, what any, like, job can offer. You are a visionary, and I always seen that in you, you know.
Well, thank you, buddy.
Hey, you know.
Now, my client, a hooting at a no visionary.
So, yeah.
You know what I'm doing.
Like, if you, like, just look at the background alone, just, like, in one shot, it's just so much going on. And it's just levels and levels on it. And just by looking at Ballpoint Universe, if you guys look at the Google here, he drew all of this. Like, all of it. He drew this.
Oh, I don't see it.
I don't think you guys get me when I say he drew
all this. Oh, your screen's white.
My screen's white?
Your screen's white.
Oh, shoot. My screen's white.
All right, I mean, that's what I'm seeing in the... Oh, no, now I see it.
Now I see it. Dang it, I wasn't even clicked on it properly. Okay, but yeah.
Well, anyway...
Are you reading the comments? Yeah.
Basically, when we were making this game, I just drew, like, a tile set. Like, because mm-hmm. you can see in the pictures, like, a lot of it repeats. So we just, like, built a tile set so that it would be able to make, like, really big levels.
And you learned this stuff yourself.
Well, Jacob. Yeah.
Oh, Jacob. Yeah, Jacob.
Yeah, the programmer.
No, but I mean, you guys are just sharing knowledge and stuff. It wasn't like here's video game making 101.
Yeah, we were just like, you know, he was like, well, here's what I know, and then yeah, we just kind of went from there.
So these are all from your sketchbook, right? I mean, your notebook.
Yeah, those are from a notebook.
Oh, cool. There's like a little GIF. So a little animation for you guys. Look at that. So,
oh yeah, from a GameSpot, I think.
Kotaku.
Yeah, it might have been Kotaku. Yeah, it was. Yeah.
A little bit of Kotaku.
Gotaku.
Gotaku. Let's see if this. Yeah, this is my laptop streaming this, and it did this. Instead, a long time ago.
Diddly do.
Yeah, there. You guys can see it here. I'm looking at it. You guys see that? Look at that guy. Backflip. Bam. Look at this. I'm going to eat you. No, I'm going to look at you. Fists. Look at that. I mean,
How do you, Leo? How do you think of this stuff? Like, how does it? How do you art?
Dude, it's
one shoe at a time, right?
You just kind of like put a pen to paper and start drawing whatever comes to mind. I mean,
yeah,
and I don't have to try to think of ideas because they're always there. It's just a matter of like the problem I had in art school and that a lot of people have is like you have this inner critic because people are always telling you like, and I mean they have a good reason to tell you like what to draw and what not to draw and like how to do it. So, you know, for the longest time, like I had this inner critic in my head, like, no, don't do that. Like whenever I would have an idea of like what to draw, it would just be like, no, don't do that. Draw a figure. Do proper. And it was like
proper. Yeah, you look at the example what they're setting for you, and then you look at your own work and you're like, wait a second, this doesn't fit the mold quite. You get the principle, right? And I think that's where you gotta take from it. You get the principle, but then there's those kind of like Nazi teachers. Like,
I mean, you can find your own voice is what it comes mm-hmm. down to.
Yeah, this is so beautiful, man. I was looking at this, and my mouth just dropped. Because you guys saw this, the paper, The Ballpoint Universe. It was very just flat. Still a lot of freaking hours of work. But now he went full on 3D. This is like something on Dreamcast as a kid. And I'd be like, Mom, we need this today.
Mom, give me that.
They have maps. They have subs. We need it. It's an adventure. Like, and it's like I said, it's like every kid's dream. Like when I see this trailer, you think of like a big company like Squaresoft or Capcom and stuff. And I don't want to just. I mean, there's probably tons better companies, and people are just like, you bastard. But anyways, you think of like a gigantic army of people. Working on it. But for you, it's four people.
Yeah, well, I think a lot of it has to do with, like, modern game engines really allow for smaller teams to build games. Like, I mean, of course, like, we can't say AAA, right? Because it's not AAA. Like, if you look at AAA games that are made by studios with, like, 500 people, they are like packed with assets and like everything is perfect and shiny and polished. And
this is Leo, by the way, you guys.
Oh no.
It's on your Kickstarter.
I know. I don't want anyone to see this.
Why not? How are you gonna freaking get people to freaking promote a sponsor or help support?
That's Jacob.
That's Jacob.
Yeah.
That's our man, Jacob.
Yeah, he's like...
I love the chair, man. It's hilarious. You guys can just ad-lib what they're saying. I think Leo really, really likes chairs. Sometimes we like to dogpile him with some chairs. Sometimes we just dog...
What are you, Benedict Cumberbatch?
We worked really hard on this project, and everyone's British.
Oh, they're British?
You should do well.
Oh, great, now my trumpets. Oh, shit, do we have any Brits in the audience?
Huh?
they're like, I'm so terribly offended right now. I wonder if we have any Australians.
Oh, we have plenty of those. Brits and Australians. But we do have our buddy Poe. He's British.
Oh shit, Poe's watching?
No, he's not on. But I mean, like, eventually he'll come on. We'll just screw on, and next time it won't be all screwy like this time. It was screwy because I'm trying to use my desktop, which is a 2008 iMac, to figure all the technical stuff, and it's just
yeah, dude.
No, like, it's like two gigs of RAM, just like. Yeah.
You gotta get a Windows.
Oh, I do. That's what I'm using now to show. I do have a PC right now. So this is now working. So people are saying. Okay, let's get some questions, you guys. I'm gonna go up to you guys' comments here. And see what you guys are thinking about all this stuff. It's been a full hour and 10 minutes. Another hot artist. I bet he has a girlfriend too. No homo.
Who, me?
No, somebody in the chat. It says, Jet, you're it. I love Leo's style. Don't know if you read it, Jet, but we made a game company in your chat last night. And our first game was playing tag in the chat.
Oh. Fire.
It doesn't look like there's any questions. You guys don't sneeze. No.
That's, that alien, I think?
Oh, blank. That is a huge wolf spider. Exactly. I love meat. Grapes, tomatoes. Yep, we can hear. Good. Jay, take over. Take over his channel. Jet has risen above normal moral vocal cords. What? I don't remember all that. But, probably don't want to see that again. So, that's that.
Hey, bro.
Saw the crab. Nope, no questions. Do you love me? Heart. Jet, will you be doing a series on how to make a manga? I certainly will. I will break it down for you, how to make a manga. What's going to do? Okay, so I'm going to draw your character. Now, will you please explain to me your character so I can draw him? Who's the character we're drawing? Okay, so this is you.
Draw my character.
Okay. I'm gonna draw your character.
Yeah.
And
Oh shit, draw Nafy.
Who?
Hold on, let me show you.
Leo, you drew these.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did those. Isol Royal Dweller, he did those. He did those, you guys. Like, I always say this to myself, like, Leo must be smoking something to get this type of imagery.
Shit. Oh, let out my secret.
No. Like, the color and the harmonies that are going on. Okay, so yeah, tell me what are these? These are the exclusive sub 2. What is this, dude? What is this all about?
Clarity.
I know you can rotate them, right? But
yeah.
What are they for? This just so you can look at, or is it gonna be like a thingy?
Oh, you can like look at it all around.
Don't be like Jet and crash a stream.
Oh, shit.
It's been so long that I've played a game. I used to always play StarCraft.
Dude, I haven't played StarCraft since I played with, like, you and Cal.
Oh. Shoot, look at this. Dude, this is like Pixar stuff.
Ah, man.
So you designed this guy? You designed him.
Yeah, I designed and painted that one.
And this one.
Yeah.
And all of them.
Yeah.
He designed all of them, guys. Dude. Long story short, he designed all of them.
You should go to, Look at the chat. I sent you a link.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I got it. Okay, what's the link all about? What's the link about?
What is that? There's a Wally. That's my favorite.
Who? I'm looking. Oh, so the character I'm going to draw, right?
Yeah.
I want to rotate this guy around first.
Oh, I remember this, dude. Taro Whitlatch.
Where?
Dude.
Oh! Oh, my screen. How did you see that? Oh, are you looking through my DeviantArt?
See it on your
under your cast.
Yeah. On my desktop?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's on my desktop. So you want me to draw her?
Yeah, man.
Tell me a little bit about her. I want to know her personality.
Oh, she's like a rocker punk girl. She's a bad girl.
Oh.
She's also a musician.
She's a bad girl. Why is she bad? She's just bad as in, like...
I don't know, because she hasn't figured out life yet.
She's in the game? I can meet her?
She's not in Diluvian, but she's in another idea.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I can tell you. She's from Fever Dream.
Ooh! And, okay. So, yeah, like I said earlier, Fever Dream is your baby, right? What are your... I mean, maybe it's too early to ask, but do you have any plans for that? Because that was just... I remember you saying you would die happy if you could finish that game. You started that game at such a young age.
Yeah, man, that's... I still really want to make it. And I think, like, after Diluvian and the expansions for Diluvian, we're going to think about making...
That is crazy, dude. I mean, could you foresee that in the future? Like, when you were, you know, as a kid, you're working on it, you're like saying to yourself, I'm working on this game. Will it be able to be, like, will it be available to the public, you know, in the future? It's going to be, you know what I mean? It's like, I'm going to have a team, I'm going to have a company, and then we're going to work on this game together.
No, when I first started, I was just kind of, like, really fascinated in making games, but I didn't have plans to do it professionally. Yeah.
So right now, I'm just drawing some pelvis and some legs. What I can do for this stream when I upload it, I can start the video later, and I think I'll just do that. And then if they wanted to, they can scroll back and see the mess. So by default, when you click on the video, you'll get just when we finally picked up speed. I think that was once when I switched over to my laptop, which is what I'm on right now drawing. So you ever watch Cowboy Bebop?
Yeah, dude. The show is awesome.
Yeah, I'm trying to watch that right now with Becky. So.
It ends too soon. I think it's like 25 episodes or something.
Yeah.
But like every episode is so good. Really sad story. I'm not going to spoil it though.
Don't spoil that one.
No, sir, you're going to watch the whole thing.
Shoot. I said shoot, you guys. Should shoot.
Shoot.
So you're gonna join us back again later in the future, right? You ain't just going to... You ain't going to be a stranger, are you? So, thinking about her emotion now. So the first one just kind of a random sketch. I don't even know what I was doing with this guy. Girl. Oh, dear. So this time around, I am just thinking of like a kind of a like bad girl. Bad girl.
Bad
attitude. I mean, like,
yeah, she's got bad attitude. Sassy.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what else I write down here. Yeah, so as you guys know, it's a small team. It's Leo, four dudes total. You guys go over there and support him. They worked really hard. If you can, and if you want to.
If you want to, like, comment, subscribe.
Like, comment, subscribe. I rarely say that. I mean, I do say it. Because I'm like, man, people.
Funny when they make it, like, I like it when Game Grumps make it as, like, contrived as possible. They're like, if you disagree with our opinions, please like, comment, and subscribe.
if you guys hated my little technical difficulty part, just like, comment, subscribe. That little fail I had earlier. Man, I was like, here's the thing, I wish, like, there was more of me, I guess, to manage it. There's just so much to manage. And I started to lose, like, sight of, like, because there's so many windows open. I was like, oh, shit. The problem really is my laptop is for drawing. It's for drawing. And then my desktop is for viewing and talking. So you hear my voice because it's connected to the computers. The desktop. That one. And I was trying to relay the sound out of the desktop into the mic, and everything just went to dookie. It went to poop.
That's a good pose.
Well, let me know which one you like, and then I'll go with it. I'll probably do one more, just one more, real quick, and then is she flirty at all?
No,
she just plays music. Flirty. Will she kick your butt?
She'll try. Yeah, she'll stab you.
Okay. That's good to know about a girl. You want to make sure you know that these things are important to know. You're gonna stab you or not?
Yeah, man.
I don't like this head. You see how this head here? This head here is going up and down. Kind of boring. If I just tilt her head, I feel like maybe it'll give us some more attitude. People always ask, how do you bring life to your drawing? And I think the life is basically when your drawing is flowing and not stiff. Once you stiffen your drawing, then it's not alive. It's not alive. So if you're drawing like a straight-on pose and you're just drawing like a stick figure like this facing forward, and I can even do like a more realistic version of that like this, you know, maybe that's not the most energetic pose. But what if I moved one of his arms a little bit this way? Then he's more alive than he was before. I think so. What if he were to bend his leg a little bit? Maybe more alive than before. Bend this one right here. Oh, and tilt the head. And then think of the overall rhythm, too, if it's not working, if it's broken. And then you can turn his body a little bit and then shoot it from a different angle. And then having the bones and everything still make sense in that weird gesture, whatever you're trying to pull off. I think that's pretty much it. It's just going to come with time and practice. Okay, one more pose. Let's figure this out. She had a guitar, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think you're going to see too much of that guitar from this angle. Box with the I'm gonna set the video to play later in the thing. So yeah, remember Skies of Arcadia? So you're influenced by that, right? You guys don't know Skies of Arcadia? That's an old Dreamcast game about pirate ships that fly in the sky. Has anybody else been able to like pick up on that? Or is it just me? Every time I see it, I'm like, Skies of Arcadia.
Yeah, it's like a cult classic. Not too many people know about it, but those that do are usually really like into it.
So how about the people working on it? Are they aware of the game? I mean, where are they before?
Wait, what?
Before, like, the people who were working on it, your team.
Yeah, what about them?
Were they familiar with the game? Skies of Arcadia.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one of my favorites. And I just love that you were able to interpret, like, not interpret, but use it as, you know, as your own influence. What is she doing? Is she doing her pick? She's like, I got a pick. Is that what she did in your drawing? She's got, I don't know, take that pick.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm going to play this guitar. You want some of this pick?
Take that pick, bruh.
You know my personal project.
No, you have multiple.
You see that Beast Guy in my profile picture?
Yeah, I remember Beast Guy.
Beast Dude.
And like the Harpies?
And the Harpies.
Yeah. They were in the same world, right?
There will be for the fun one. It'll be like adventuring. No, I don't want to block your body, so.
Come on, rock your body.
All right. Oh, shit. All right, which pose do we got here? Do you want me to do?
I still think the one on the left is like the most.
This one? Okay. Alright, we'll do that one. Oh, no. This happens sometimes when my pen does that. So I have to click on my Wacom. Like that. There it goes. Hey, what's up, Ezra Brown? Hi, Thunderman. How are you doing? I'm not oblivious, Rujin Dynasty. I can see you. I misspelled profanity, facepalm, heartbeats, master. I'm not oblivious, you guys. I'm not. I love the proportions you got going for this girl. It's the fun one, you know what I mean? It's the fun. Leo.
Yeah.
Aside from art, what do you do?
Rock climbing.
Oh?
I climb on rocks.
Nice.
And I watch a lot of YouTube. Like, I watch a lot of Game Grumps.
Cool.
And Jontron.
Jontron.
And I play video games.
Play the video game. Uh-huh. Now, how's your schedule like in this whole thing?
I usually work like 10 to 6.
Nice.
And, yeah, I just get home and then do whatever.
Now, what do you do to get up in the morning? How do you, like...
What do you mean?
Like waking up. What helps you? Like what helps you get up, and what helps you get a nice full rest at night? For you anyway, because I'll let them know I do.
A lot of times I don't get up on time, so.
Yeah.
Like, I guess setting a lot of alarms helps me get up, and coffee. Yeah.
Nice. Coffee. The coffee. Yeah.
Yeah, man, coffee helps.
Well, that's one of the things I needed. It's coffee. Boop, boop. It's from Fever Dream. Fever Dream. What else can you tell us about Delivian? I guess Leo didn't hear me. It's cool. I'm gonna let him know. You guys know how I wake up. Yeah. I hear.
Yeah, how do you, bro?
What? Hello?
Yeah, tell the good people.
So this is a brand new one, and I'm not the only one who does it because I read an article, and you guys can look it up too. How does I just looked at how? How can sleeping in the nude benefit you? It can benefit you in a lot of ways, including waking up early. So yeah, I've adopted a new way of sleeping. I actually sleep naked now, and it's done wonders for me. Like I get up now in the morning, and I just get up. I'm like, oh, I'm naked. I gotta put on pants. Oh dear. Oh no. Yeah.
Dude, pants.
That's pretty much it, you guys. Clothes.
Sometimes at work, I like to take off pants.
Yeah, at work, you take off pants?
Only if it's like a hot day.
No.
Yeah, man. It's really liberating. The better ventilation that way.
See, you always do like these things with like objects and accessories and found objects sometimes, and it's the intricate little details that makes your character so interesting.
That's what I think is fun to draw. Yeah, really good, dude. I think they've improved since I've last seen your work.
I've been drawing a lot, dude. You've improved. It's good to see.
Yeah, man, you've been
doing... still on the battlefield.
A lot of doobity-doos.
I've been doing a lot of doobity-doos. It's those little things, and I'm about to draw one right now. It's just the necklace of the girl. Maybe I better look at this here. Necklace here. For me, I'm like too scared to push the drawing and make it bold. It's like an upside down heart, right?
The necklace?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or is it like from the cards? The
upside down heart, otherwise known as a butt.
The butt. Or yeah. Boobs, depending on.
Yeah, either one.
Yeah. Okay. They are talking. I'm moving from Ohio to Florida next week, so I know it's going to be a big change. Where are you going? You gonna go to Florida for wrangling? What are you doing there?
TMI, Chad. That's funny. I like TMI. You, Thunder.
There's like a design in her shirt, behind her shirt, and it's like an X thing.
Where?
On her shirt.
I don't remember. I drew this a long time ago.
Like an X shape.
Show me the picture.
I am. It's screen sharing.
Oh. Where?
Radio.
No X.
Underneath it. There's like a
nails hold the heart in place.
Huh?
These are nails.
That's Oh, weird. Shoot, that's not from her. That's not her shirt.
No, that's part of the necklace.
Hi, that's even cooler. Thank goodness. It would have been so flat looking.
The boobadosh.
So she got the nails. So cool. She got the nails to hold. You guys hear that? Just saying it sounds cool, man. Got the nails, man, to hold my heart in place. Wow. And like, what? For real? Yeah, man. I can't take the nails out because my heart's upside down. They're nailed in place. That's deep, brother. That's deep. What are the shapes here? It's kind of a low res file, but I see some like kind of a thorny looking triangles, maybe triangle shapes. Yeah, I see it. And then she has like a beads for her.
Yeah.
It's not even just a flat collar, see? I would have just went with flat collar, but Leo goes to the next step. So you can do character design. My character design class was shite. And then triangles, right?
Oh. Trying to get my cats away from my table. Dude, little cats are so curious. getting all the stuff. I'm like, damn.
You had a cord kind of connecting them, and then you did it. Triangles. So yeah, man, what kind of what do you recommend for kids? What kind of portfolio they need to get a job like yours?
Like mine?
Yeah.
Good, dude. There's.
What kind of portfolio?
Route.
What was it? Say it again. You cut out.
Which is like the opposite of what they'll tell you if you want to become a production artist.
You cut out. You got to start back. You said you, which is the opposite, which they what they tell you, and what was before that?
Okay, so
yeah,
if you want to get like a stable job at a larger game company, then you should draw the subject matter of whatever company it is that you want to get to. Like, it's like they want to basically, if you're going to apply for a job like that, you're doing them a favor. Like, that's the whole point. Mm-hmm. You want to make their lives easier. That's not what I do. Like, if you want to go the indie game route, which is like kind of the position I'm in, then your entire existence depends on you standing out. Like, you have to do something that AAA games aren't doing. So if there's like some aspect of your work that like is really unique, or that you kind of like that people are always drawn to, then that's what you should push. But I mean, it all depends on the person. Like, it's not for everyone.
Hold on, people are saying it's frozen. They can, it's frozen, but can you guys still hear? Let us know in the comments. Maybe I turned.
Oh, yeah.
No, it's frozen at the turn, so it was recent. So you guys can hear.
Okay, I think the stream is... No, it's not back yet.
It's not back yet?
No. It's still loading.
Okay. How's your internet connection at your place?
It's okay. It's like so-so.
Okay. Oh, it's back. I think it's back. Yeah, it's back. Looks like it.
Dude, you're welcome. Yasin? Am I saying that right? Jivian Yasin?
Chavoid? He's one of our frequent Javoin.
Javoin.
Sure. Yeah. So yeah, you can continue now. Please continue. Yeah, Leo.
Oh, dude.
They want to do what you're doing. How do I get a portfolio? Because they're always asking, like, I'm working on my portfolio, and we're all taught to build a portfolio. Build a portfolio! You're going to graduate. Make a portfolio. Because they're going to want to see your work.
Yeah, man. Portfolios is good.
Portfolio is good.
Wait. Did all the stuff I said about...
I think they heard. Yeah, I think they heard. No, I think they heard most of it.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Because that like left my brain.
Okay, that's fine. You know what reminds me? What your forehead thing right here? This reminds me of
what?
One of my favorite cartoons. It's not appropriate for kids.
Which one?
Vampire Hunter D.
Oh, that's like.
It is.
The artist for that's one of my favorite illustrators.
Yeah.
Amano.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. That guy's awesome.
Yeah. You did a Final Fantasies?
Japanese movie.
Amano Yoshitaki?
No, only like real ass Japanese food. Like a big ass plate just full of sashimi.
Yeah. That's what you're going to eat right now?
No, that's what I want to eat. But I'm going to eat cheese because that's what I have. Hey, cut that out. I'm trying to eat my blanket. Not you, Jet, the cat.
Okay.
Just try to eat everything.
Oh,
my God, it looks so delicious. I'm, like, looking at Japanese food.
You're looking at Japanese food.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, dude. The eyes, the forehead thing, it's so Mono Yoshitake.
Dude, it's just it's what comes out.
Yeah, no, it's...
Oh, I like your rendition of her.
I'm trying.
Looks sexy.
I'm trying to do it in my style, but also capture your essence.
Yeah, I want to see it in your style. Oh, have you ever had whale egg?
Oh, yeah. I grew up with that.
Dude, it's so delish.
Yeah, it is. It's good.
Whale egg.
Quail egg.
I like it when it's pickled.
Ooh.
Pickled quail egg.
You've had 1,000-year-old egg?
Ew. Yeah, no. That's no. Different.
My bad.
Never,
not the 1,000-year-old egg. I meant to say 1,000-year-old lemon.
yeah, I think I had that at your house.
Or 100-year-old lemon. They call it that, yeah. And then...
Yeah.
It looks like a big old black and brown lemon that's been like pickled for so long. It's so good. It's good. You drop into your soup. I think I cooked it for you too, Leo, at the Oakland apartment before, if you don't remember. It was yummy.
I cooked it while we were in Oakland.
We were speaking Oaklandese.
Dude, that was with Diane, too.
Yeah, Diane's doing things.
Three artists, and then cow.
And then a cow. A cowboy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh!
What's that? He bit you, didn't he?
Bit my butt. And it hurt.
Leo, we gotta have you back on here, I swear.
Oh, hey, someone pointed out something about the arms.
What are they? Too low, the elbows? Yeah.
No, the arm. Like, the one, like, the forearm doesn't connect to the hand.
What?
Like, the underneath arm? Like, underneath the other.
It's so, yeah, you're so right, everybody.
It was someone in the comments that said that.
Nice. I would have been forever fail.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You done good.
You done good. Thanks for pointing it out, man. Like, all the credit goes to Leo. No all credit right. For the audience.
Just
That's right.
So we yeah.
Oh man, I want to see. No. Oh, she can have her pick right here, dude. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out where she can put her pick. Right? She's like, ding, 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 ding. What?
Hey, boo boo.
Hey, boo boo.
Get some picnic basket.
Some picnic baskets. Ooh. She got those pockets right there. She got those belt loops right there. Yeah. And then she's got these ties on her legs. Yeah.
Wait, no, I'm not drawing right now. This is Jet.
What are you talking about, Leo? This is you.
Oh, wait, no. Someone said you do that well. I think they were talking about the Yogi Bear.
The Yogi Bear accent.
Azarius says, "I'm going to Florida for computer animation at Full Sail. He wants your opinion."
Shoot. I do not support or endorse any.
Oh, okay.
No, that's not what I meant to say. I meant to say, I heard a lot of bad things about that school. But don't have to take my word. Dun-dun-dun.
Well, I think it depends on what major.
Yeah. I had a friend who went to Full Sail, and he just, like, constantly bashing on it. Like, really? It's that bad?
I don't know. That's actually one of the schools that I checked out before going to Canada.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hmm. They were founded on, like, sound design, I think. Like, audio and sound was the original major there.
Mm-hmm. We'll do this. Well, it is. All the way down to the feet, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You got any plans to come down to Sacramento soon?
Say what?
So you have any plans to come down to Sacramento anytime soon?
No, dude, I don't have a car anymore.
Oh, you sold it.
You got plans to come to SF?
I might, yeah. I think so. After we finish this haul of work, you got a lot of work ahead of you. I got a lot of work ahead of me. To finish that, we'll do a little celebration. Let's go camping.
Dude, that'd be awesome. Go to Yosemite.
Yeah, we go camping. How many times have we gone camping before? Twice?
I think we went together twice.
Yeah.
Because the one time we went, like, with Santa, and then we went with, like, just me and Cal and Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, no, we went twice with Santa.
Yeah. Something like that. Dude, her outfit is freaking awesome.
Hey.
Shay. Well, I could just shut.
Man, why is cheese so good?
Oh, it's all that fat, man. It goes to your brain. And it says, hello. Hello, I make you feel good, don't I?
Like, hello, it's going to go straight to my thighs.
Wow, 48 people watching. Thanks, everybody. If you're just joining the show, we have Leo Dasso on the
show
today. Video game company founder, extraordinaire.
Video games,
and I'm just drawing one of his characters from the game. You guys didn't miss much if you're just joining. She got those spike. Ooh, those earrings. Manager. There. Because cheese is everything good in life. Ghost says.
Dude, cheese is like fully unique as a food because it's the only food that can be all of the food group. Because you got like cheese bread.
Mm-hmm.
The grains food group. You got cheese itself, which is the dairy food group.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there's no fruit cheese.
I was waiting for that.
But like those cottage cheese packs where you put the fruit in it.
Mm-hmm.
The fruit food group.
Mm-hmm. I'm hella dumb. I put this little spike on her head. This earring.
And it can also be dessert. Because cheesecake. It's got everything covered. Like, if I had to be stranded on a desert island, I would want to be stranded on one that just, like, grew cheese out of the ground.
Yeah, man.
Or maybe omelets.
Do you like saying feta or feta?
Dude, it's like the same, like the meta and meta target.
Data, data. Well, Boogie Monster has a clear winner out of the two. Which one do you like? There.
Got no bread, don't get on that table.
Dang, that's really good.
They're saying, okay. Rujin Dynasty said 2 hours in, nothing has happened. What are you talking about? Is the screen frozen? Frozen.
I said, dude, apparently blueberry cheese is real.
Beta. Well, I like to say feta.
So Azaria. Neither of us are like animators.
Yeah.
But I do work with some computer animators, and I think, like, Maya is, like, the tool that they use.
Yeah. So, but you've done animation in the past.
Yeah, but not, like, seriously.
You just winged it, and it worked still, you know? I think that's good to experiment.
Yeah, so definitely, like, learn Maya. I think there's, like, educational version that you can get for free. And that's all the tips I can offer for now. Like, I don't really know much about it.
There it is. It's all of them.
Yeah. Do you draw faster digital or traditional?
Who, me?
Yeah.
For real, digital. All digital.
Yes.
Just been using it for so long.
Ram.
I got that undo. You're traditional. You always do traditional.
Yeah, I like traditional. Dude, speaking of computer animation, you know South Park is done in Maya.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like they.
Oh.
Like. Still,
thought it was a Flash.
Just like easier to do it in Maya.
What? I thought it was Flash, right?
Nah.
Nah.
But if you go back and like look at
So all the people that I told that it was in Flash, I just like led them astray.
Oh shit! You just ruined their life.
Hold yeah, on. That's yeah. all they were just living yeah. on. So.
Dude, you totally gotta come over. When you're in the Bay.
Yeah.
We'll, like, stay up all night playing Halo. Because, oh, yeah. You can play online and, like, talk shit to people.
Yeah.
And, like, capture their...
What I like to do on Halo was, back in the day, was call them, like, names in, like a third grader, maybe, like, no, like a second grader. No, second grader still. Like a preschooler. Like a preschooler. They're like...
Butt face.
You bleep, 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 bleep. I was like, you poo-poo head, pee-pee mouth. Like, who let the little kid in here? Face. They're just, like, getting really, really angry. They use all the worst terms you can. I'm just like, don't make me stoop down to your level. This is totally out of perspective. Oh, it's so bad.
Dude.
What?
You use the,
Transform? Huh?
Like, the neck is bent. The neck guitar.
The neck is, huh?
Like it's gotta be a straight line all the way from the, Like, all the way from the tip to the center of the other end of the guitar.
Okay, let me just oh.
I just wanted to tell you that before you did, like, a lot of details on it.
Yeah, I got you. Right on. Thanks. Thanks for that, Leo. Maybe I do it this way instead. This way it'll come towards us. Yeah. So, like that. I'm sorry, I changed her hand positioning of the guitar. I feel that maybe going this way would work a little bit better, but then... Now I'm having trouble. I'm not doing underdrawing. It's going right over the clean lines.
Yeah, now you got it.
terrible ideas.
From Flagon.
Dude, you know Casey Green?
Nope.
Have you read the Gun Show comic?
No. Why?
Dude, guy's like one of my favorite artists.
The Gun Show. The Gun Show?
Yeah, the Gun Show. It's so fucking funny.
You gotta show me.
I will show you.
Alright. Probably just do a silhouette for now. This real quick. Do you take breaks when you're drawing? Or do you like to do like long marathons? Okay, I'm looking at it now. It's hot over here. Someone says, I had so much trouble transitioning into digital.
Go far, babe. Remember that?
Huh.
Remember Bobby Girl? Bobby song?
I can barely hear you. What?
Oh, dude, hold on.
I'm looking at it. Oh, it's like Ren and Stimpy and stuff. Not really Ren and Stimpy, but yeah, you know. Cool. So this is by one guy?
Gun Show?
Yeah.
Yeah, bruh.
That's cool, bruh.
He's a weird-ass artist.
his drawings are spunky. And he's telling little short comics. So that's that. And then I will do a little That sounds familiar.
I think it's like some theme song from an RPG.
Which one is that?
I don't know. Street Hawk?
Street Hockey?
I don't know what you play these days. Street Hawk! Jontron?
Jontron!
I bet it's super entertaining for me to quote other YouTube videos on your cast.
Just go with this one. I'm going to put a little value down, flat value, maybe pull out some lights, some darks, and some shadows, and that's it. No colors, because it's 10 o'clock.
Oh my god, it is.
Yeah, it went by fast.
Dude. Did it as it was. Is that your usual, like, 2 hours?
Huh? Yeah, well, hour and a half. Or my usual is actually, like, 3 hours. But then okay. I always say I want to go for an hour. I always say that. Go for an hour. 3 hours passed. One time I said, I'll go for 15 minutes, and I went for 3 hours. 4 hours.
Well, that's
A little bit of a dip. A little bit off of the time. So, let's answer the question of the stream. We'll probably just do this for another 20 minutes and then call it a night. How do you make a video game company? How to do it? What are the steps? How to tutorial?
How do I what?
How do you make a video game company?
Oh. There's two things that you need.
Yeah.
To do that. You gotta know how to program, or like know somebody that can program.
Yeah.
And you gotta know someone that can design. Like, you don't necessarily have to like be an artist, but like you need to know how to design, like have your characters stand out from the background and like make color choices that make sense. Because like you see games out there that still look really good, but they don't have really any artwork in them. It's all just like blocks. And there's still like a designer behind that.
Yeah.
The other thing is like start early. Because once you graduate, it becomes like really hard to get into it.
Oh, you're breaking up. Once you what now?
Like, once you, when you're still a student, you can practice it and like.
Oh, once you graduate.
Yeah.
But
like once you graduate, it becomes more difficult because like you gotta make a living for yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. But the number one thing you gotta have is like you gotta have passion for making games if you wanna like start your own company, because it's extremely difficult. Like, there's a lot to learn, even if you're using an engine that has already been built.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, there's a lot of people doing it. There's a lot of small companies just like us that, you know, it's just like a couple guys that are really wanted to make games. So, not impossible.
Mm-hmm.
I think that about covers it.
Yeah, about does it.
That about do. Now, Your Honor, my client here, over there, right about.
Saturday, true. You got a Saturday drink about? Not exactly out of the old affinity. Excuse me, affinity. As if you understand what I'm saying in the first place.
Excuse me. Oh. It's about time for me to put on my lipstick and high heels. Go out in the night.
Are you going to go out tonight?
Nah, tonight I'm chilling at home and sketching.
Nice.
Doing a chill, chill.
Guys didn't know he was in an impersonation of Chris Kattan. That was one of the things I noticed about Leo. He kind of acts like Chris Kattan.
Oh shit, we got some more questions coming in.
Okay.
This one should go to you. Someone who's starting to make a manga.
Okay. You made a manga. What was the question?
Yeah, that's the question. Like,
oh, I didn't get it. It glitched. What you just said?
Oh, what advice would you give to someone who's just starting to make a manga?
Oh, okay. So, I would say, with any storytelling, keep it simple. First of all, I'm not working on my personal manga. I'm working for somebody else. The manga that I'm working on isn't for any myself, so keep that in mind. But I think you just got to keep the story simple and keep it limited to a few characters that you can build a story from. And start small. Start something small. It can just be like a one-page thing. I think that's just enough to get experience in making a couple panels and stuff. Leo, you have a lot of experience making. You made your own manga or comic. Mm-hmm. What would you say?
No, oh, dude, I didn't. I never had a manga.
Not manga, but comic with Andrew Marr.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I have a copy of that, dude. You guys did it.
We did a 20-page comic just for fun. I don't know. I'm not good enough to give advice on that. Like that's.
Well, if they want to start off, like just simple. Just...
Oh, yeah, yeah. Just start off like just kind of like plan out the whole thing. Like just sketch the whole thing quickly before you go in and do the details. Because then you kind of get a flow of it.
Yeah.
Just get into the groove of things, and then once you get the whole thing like plotted out, that's when you go back in and like, fill in all the details.
Yeah, and also you guys can look up if you're really interested in making manga, look up and read Scott McCloud. I got the book, and I'm in the process of reading it. It's taking me years to read. It's not a hard read. It's just it's a good book. You can learn a lot out of that book. There's that, and yeah. Like Leo said, start off simple, keep everything nice and loose, and just I like to look at it as stages, just like in a rough draft. Like I did, in an illustration, you have the rough draft, then first you have like a really rough idea, and then you have the rough draft, then you have the pencils, then you have the inks, then you have the colors. You break it down in pieces like that. If you do your layout first, just figure out where all the characters are placed in the drawing. Which way they're facing. They can be stick figures. That's what layout is. And you're also figuring out where, how high or how low they are positioned in the camera, in the shot. So that's layout. From there, you do some rough drafts, some really scribbly lines. And then from there, you do pencils, which is close to inks. It can be even as clean as inks. But it's just basically making your lines refined enough so that you know what is happening, like, precisely. You know, as an inker, as a person who's clicking, you know cleaning, you know exactly what lines you wanted and what lines you don't. And after that, you ink it. I think with anything, it starts off with the stories. Write it out. Just write a story out. I'm not working for myself, so just giving myself these notes too to think about when I start working on my own thing.
Okay, I think there's one more question. Hold on.
Nice. We'll go for about 7 more minutes and that's it. Yeah. What?
I
lost.
Ask strong connections, and what do you do for marketing? Well, that's two questions.
Can you say it again? You kind of broke up there. Sorry.
Yeah, strong connections you get by like collaborating with people.
Mm-hmm.
Like just find other people that like to do what you do, and then approach them. Just be like, hey, like I like your work. I also do that. We should work together because you know, you never know what position they'll end up in. Be authentic about it, you know.
That brings me to a good point. I think we talked about it. I think it's kind of late in the game, but I wanted to talk about the whole idea of networking and how we thought of it before we went to school and how it actually turned out. Because a lot of times when people ask you, and when you tell them, like, art school is not what I expected, and I kind of regret going, you know what I mean? I don't say I regret going, but, you know, you definitely feel like you could have taken a different route, you know? They always reply, well, you at least you got networking, right? You got the networks, and you go, yeah, I got the networks. And then the more I thought about it, I was like,
My networks really didn't get me to where I needed to be. And I was just like, yeah, so networking, it wasn't like how we imagined it to be. We thought we got friends who get into the position, and then we're like, yeah, I'm going to piggyback off of you. You got the job. You're in. You got your foot in the door. The problem with that is your friend had a hard enough time to get in it, and like everyone's just like having trouble getting work, and then your friend, you know, would love to help, but it's just difficult for them because such a competitive industry. And what you can do, like, go ahead.
Like if a friend is in a position where they actually can help, then I think they will. But a lot of the time, it's like they don't have the power to. Like, they can suggest to you, but it's like, well, the company's not hiring, or like, well, it's independent.
Exactly. So,
yeah.
Exactly. So, like, they can suggest you, but, like, what is, you know, if they're not hiring, then... And it's just so difficult to get work since it's just hard to get work out here. So, that brings me to the point about how can you network? Just what Leo just said. Make friends, you know, and if find people who are interested in the same thing you are, and then collaborate with them. Those are your networks, and then produce something together. And Leo worked with one of our friends and made this his company. Pretty much.
I guess it emphasized that there was money involved for that particular incident. It wasn't like, hey, do this for me. Especially in school, a lot of people are willing to totally just work with you, like, without any money involved, because it's, you know, it's like both of you are new to it, and it's fun to work with someone else.
Let's see. 3 more minutes, so maybe I can do a little more. You know what I learned from you, Leah?
Emerald.
She looks emerald, huh? Yeah.
Same kind of. That's a cool color scheme, actually. Remind me of the Emerald City.
She's Emerald City. I was gonna say, you know, I learned a lot of color techniques from you, actually. But really? one of the most important coloring techniques was actually taught by Leo. It's crazy, right? It's like,
oh shit.
Well, didn't you take color design? Yeah, I did. But one of the most effective things that I learned was you. You said when things get lighter, they also get warmer when they hit the light. Depending on the situation, if it gets cooler, it would be in the shadow. If it gets brighter and cooler, more in shadow. And, dude, I never forgot that. And like every time I do that in my drawings, I think of you. I go, Leo taught me that.
You touch yourself a little bit.
Huh?
And you think of me, and you're like. This is like.
What are you saying right now? I can barely hear you. You're like glitching.
I'm watching the chat closely to see if anyone reacts to that.
No.
Oh, and the rumors will speak.
That's the truth. Isn't that crazy? Like, I lifted off one of the teachers from color and design, but that was his technique of lighting objects was how to make it realistic as they brighten up. Make it warm at the same time, and he showed me how to do that on the hue saturation bar, and and then I remember applying that all over the place. After I learned that, I was like, dude, this is added to my arsenal. And you look at my my creature design drawings, dude, I was all over that. I was like, man, Leo gave me this, he gave it to me. He's like,
yeah, man. You know what I learned from you?
What'd you learn from me?
I learned how to be loose and swift, like a tiger in a river.
Did you see a tiger in the river?
Yeah.
Nice.
Like
did I really?
Just like whoop, 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 like with your life.
Did I really teach you how to be loose like a tiger in the river?
Yeah, dude. Like a flying tiger caught in the
river. That's pretty awesome.
Or like a snake in the dryer.
What in the dryer?
A snake.
A snake in the dryer?
Hey, why that dude's penis out?
Huh?
What this ding dang things are on dicks? Oh shit, thank you, Taco Cat. Taco Cat says Lubin looks amazing.
Yeah, man.
That I'm Taco Cat.
Yeah. That's what we're saying, you guys. The Lubin looks amazing. Oops. Oh dear. The wrong
bye. Oh, how quaint.
Yep. So I'm just gonna not there.
Yes.
Yeah.
They're talking about the dick that
what?
Devoian, like.
Oh no.
The dude's dick hanging out?
No!
It's happening in the chat right now.
Yeah, I know Javoyan.
Yeah.
Yeah. He said he's doing it for somebody or something like that. And then, like, it's just like this proud anime dude. And he's just got his penis out.
Hey, man, it's part of the human body. It's not that.
Yeah, but he's got, like, a cape and a boxer and boxers.
That's awesome. That's what I want for Halloween.
That's pretty awesome. It is. I mean, he was pretty happy about it. Like, the guy in the pose, he was just like...
He's like, yeah, that's right.
Like, loud and proud.
Breast.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I'm just gonna... That's it. That's maybe a little, just for the shadows. We'll do a little hit here. Oh no! The shadow looked dumb over here. Why did it happen like that? It's too dark.
Dude, I tell you about the time I was in the bar. I was in
the barn.
Found a ring.
What are you saying? It's...
I found a
totally turning into a robot, dude.
Found a floor. You hear me now? Am I still a robot?
You're still a robot, dude.
What the fuck, man? How about now?
Said, I heard the last part.
Oh shit, you're a robot now. Yo, the chat says sweet drawing, Jeff.
What?
It says sweet drawing. I really like it.
Oh, thanks. 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 Guitar's pretty just pretty basic, but let's try to use a little. Based off of Leo's design, of course. I just kept the guitar a silhouette shape because I'm trying to save time here. Oh, dude, are you watching Game of Thrones? Oh, Leo. Leo disappeared. Leo!
Yeah.
I'll wait for him. Oh, there you are. I was waiting for you to come back, and then we'll end it. So that there, what's her name?
Nifty.
Oh, Nifty?
Yeah.
It's Nifty.
Yeah.
Oh, I said it right. Cool.
Yeah, you did it. I was canceled.
Dude. I was can't hear, dude. I swear. I was can't hear. Steven, I'm Steven. Oh, shoot. Steven is... I've been talking to Steven lately. We're gonna do a show.
Oh, yeah?
And, it'd be cool if you joined us, too. Just, you know Steven.
Of course I know Steven.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do, Mr. Robot.
We're talking to the dudes.
Yeah, dude. I can. Yeah, you're cutting in and out, but I'm gonna end the show.
Okay.
And then show if you.
Just, all right.
Yeah, you're just totally.
Bye, guys.
How about you type in your last words, and then I'll read it. But I'm gonna basically say, you guys, please go over there and support Leo's project, the Luvion. It's on Kickstarter. It's in the link below. You guys enjoy the show. Sorry about the big old technical difficulty. We'll work on it. Hope you come back and join us again soon, Leo. It was amazing. Thank you so much for having us. I mean, having. Thank you for joining. And everybody else, this is Bye, everyone. Thanks for watching our dual double super jet show spectacular. Tell your friends about Diluvian. You guys know the rest. Like, subscribe. And as we like to do on the Jetty Jet Shazam, is we make a, I guess, say, bada bada boom, peace. I don't know if you can do that for us. So take care. Good luck. And as always, many the beast.